Hello everyone, I am Tanmay Pawar, an automation engineer. Today we are going to learn about Siemens programming software, that is TIA version 13. TIA is totally integrated automation used to program PLC, HMI and SCADA. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to configure PLC and its input and output cards in software. Also, we will learn HMI hardware configuration in the software. Then we'll learn about communication part for downloading PLC software in actual PLC hardware. Okay, let's start with TIA software. So click on start button and double click on TIA portal V13. Then go to create new project. Then you can write a project name. We are writing here hardware config and then press create button. So it will take some time. After that, click on project view. Once it opens, then you have to add device, that is PLC. So click on add new device button. So it will show you a window. Then you can see controllers, HMIs and PC systems, that is SCADA systems. So we'll be selecting a controller. So we have to configure PLC. So we need a hardware list for that, hardware specification list, which I have already prepared. So that is hardware specification list. You can see PLCs, its model numbers, digital input, output, analog, whole list is there. So by referring to this list, we'll select PLC with exactly same details. You can see here CPU1214C, DC, 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 and its number, model number. So we'll be selecting same PLC number in our software. So you can see here, we'll be matching both the numbers and then we will add it into our software. Now you can see description about the PLC, its memory, input and output, as well as version part. So after that, you can click on OK. So now you have configured PLC. Now you have to add digital inputs. So same procedure you will follow for digital input. You will go into hardware catalog and compare the numbers. And you will simply drag it and drag at position number 2, slot number 2. Similarly, you can see you have to add DQ. So same procedure you will follow and add into the next slot, that is slot number 3. Same procedure for analog input. You can compare the numbers. And one thing you should make sure is you cannot put one of the slot empty and then add the next card there. So that is not allowed. So this is not valid. So you have to put card immediately next to your previously added card. So that precaution is to be taken. Now you can see here communication cards you can add at 101, 102 and 103. So actually we don't have our communication card part right now in this tutorial, so I am not going to add, but this is for your information. And you cannot add communication cards, Profibus communication cards, into IO cards and vice versa. You cannot add IO cards into communication card slots. So communication cards must be added to the left side of the PLC while IO should be added to right side of the PLC. Now once this is done, we can add our HMI, that is KTP600. It is key touch panel HMI, 6 inch of HMI. So we have to select KTP600 basic, and you can see few variants having different communication protocols like Profinet or MPI, PPI. So we'll go for Profinet with color display. You can see here it is a grayscale display, but we are going for color 256 colors display. So we'll select this mode, which we have already selected in our hardware description. So again, you have to match numbers here as well. Okay, then click on finish button. You can see HMI is getting added. It will take few moments. Now you have to go into device and networks to link your PLC and HMI. So click on device and networks. You can see this is Ethernet port, or you can say Profinet port. So we have Profinet port on PLC and HMI. So simply drag your Ethernet port from PLC to HMI. Automatically PNI link will get created. Click on PLC. You can now set IP for your communication. So we will be setting IP for our PLC. So click on Ethernet address. You can see 192.168.0.1. That is your IP address for the PLC. And for same for the HMI, you have to configure IP address, which should be different from the PLC as well as your PC. And not only that, but also all the components, devices that you are going to connect should have a different IP address. Unique IP address is required. So you can rename your HMI device, and you can also rename your PLC device. So we'll be renaming our HMI device. So I'll be renaming it to HMI application, HMI_application. So just click outside the properties tab, then go to network view, and you can click on PLC. So you can see PLC. Now you can rename PLC as PLC application. Similarly, you can also edit names for your digital as well as analog cards. Now click on PLC application, and you can press a download button. So one window will come where you have to add few parameters, like connection interface we are using is PNI. So when you place that, you can start search. When actual PLC is connected to PC, then automatically that IP will come. You have to go to control panel, go to set PGPC interface, and now here you have to select active part as a PNI. Then go to your system and check your address in LAN connection, local connection. Double click there. Go to IPv4 and set a different IP with the same subnet mask and in the same domain. That is 192.168.0.15. Now you can see it is having a different IP. Now you can click on load button and PLC will get downloaded. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe and share.